Four 7-bit binary values are transmitted from one computer to another. A parity bit is added to each binary value, creating 8-bit binary values. All the binary values are transmitted and received correctly. Identify whether each 8-bit binary value has been sent using odd or even parity by writing odd or even in the type of parity column. So to complete this table, we're going to figure out if we are using odd or even parity with this 8-bit binary value. To give you the context, we have computer A and computer B, and we want to transfer some data from A to B. To ensure that data arrives correctly at B, we're going to be using this type of error checking method called the parity check. The idea with the parity check is we take our message and split it up into segments of 7 bits. We then check what the parity is of that 7-bit segment, and we set the parity bit to either be 1 or 0. This is usually the first bit. So for each of these 8-bit values, the parity bit has been set. We need to figure out what type of parity we're using. Are we using odd parity? Or are we using even parity? The way that we differentiate between the two types of parity is based on the number of ones in our binary number. If there is an odd number of ones, this uses odd parity. If there is an even number of ones, we're using even parity. Let's go through each of these, and we're going to count the number of ones within this binary number. In this case, we have 3 ones, hence the parity is going to be odd. The second one, we also have 3 ones, so the parity is going to be odd. The third one, we have 2 ones, so the parity is even. And the fourth one, there are 4 ones, so this is going to be even parity. When these bytes are received by B, B does the process that we just did, where it checks the number of ones in the number. In the last case, we had even parity. If B detects an odd number of ones, in other words, one of the bits within our binary number is flipped, that means that there was an error during transmission. We're going to request A to resend that byte. Question B says an error may not be detected when using a parity check. Identify why an error may not be detected. When we're speaking about detecting an error, we're speaking about the process that happens at B when we're checking the parity of the bits. If all we're doing is checking the number of ones, there are a number of things that we could miss. For example, what if two of the bits has flipped places? Let's say we had the binary number 011, 00100. We then transmitted this from A over to B. Imagine now that the first 2 bits flipped. So we have 10100100. These are 2 completely different binary numbers, but they both have an odd number of ones. The receiver B would mark this as a correct binary number, even though the byte is incorrect. We call this a transposition error. So let's go ahead and write that down as our first answer. And there we go, that is our question complete.